Oh, cloud storage. We make it sound so magical. All your data just floating around in the heavens around you. But the cloud is really just your information living on someone else's hard drive. We're all probably familiar with external and portable drives, but what if you could access your external hard drive from anywhere you had an internet connection? Let's get your storage attached to a network. Great explainers, industry news, gadget reviews, and upcoming contests. Make sure you hit all those little subscribe options down below to keep up with the whole crew here on reviews.org. This is one of my absolute favorite home networking topics, network attached storage. If you're managing a home full of data connected devices, dealing with backups and handling media, there's something so liberating about hooking up a hard drive directly to the internet. It's like a cloud that you have total control over. You manage it, you set the passwords for it, and you can unplug it or move it whenever you need to. And depending on costs, buying a hard drive might be more cost-effective in the long run than bumping up your online storage subscription. I love it when a gadget name almost perfectly describes what a gadget should do. Network attached storage. Okay, when we take a hard drive and we plug it into a computer, the computer can see the contents of that drive. Instead, if we have a drive that connects to a router, then any computer, phone, tablet, or TV that we give permission to can access the contents of that drive. And best of all, modern network storage is pretty easy to use locally or remote. I can access the contents of that drive while I'm on my home Wi-Fi, or I can talk to that drive when I'm out on the town on LTE or 5G. The drive can send and receive info over the internet without being directly connected to a traditional computer. The world of network storage is pretty broad, from simple consumer solutions to the big storage arrays that corporations might use. A solid starter option, several companies sell single drive NAS options that look just like standard external hard drives. Instead of a USB plug on the back, you'll see an Ethernet port to connect up to a router. You fire up that company's management software on a PC, you can use Windows or macOS to find that drive on your network, or use an app on a phone or a tablet. There's a big lump of storage that is always accessible to back up your data and share your files. What's been fun, what's been exciting to watch over the last several years, the evolution of small office and home solutions for more powerful NAS products. Instead of one hard drive, you can run a little box with multiple hard drives inside. And this gives you more flexibility for how much storage you want to buy and how you can manage and protect that data. It's probably worth a video all on its own, so if you'd like to see that video, drop a comment down below. But there are a couple different flavors of data organization. Let's say you have a two-drive enclosure. That means physically there are two hard drives inside. We can put a 1 terabyte drive in each bay. Now, you can use that enclosure as one big lump of storage. Yep. 1 plus 1 equals 2 terabytes. Or we can tell the enclosure to copy the same data on both drives. You'll only have 1 terabyte of total storage that you can use, but if one drive fails, the other drive will still have all of your data. This is known as mirroring your information. There are several different methods of cutting up data across multiple drives. My NAS has 3 drives, but only shows the full storage capacity of 2 drives. And the data is spread out in a way where any one drive can fail and I can still access and recover all of my data. You can take this concept pretty much as far as your budget can handle. Pricing on enclosures and individual drives climbs with complexity, but it's really easy these days to plan out how much storage you might need and still give yourself plenty of room to grow. My little 3-drive NAS backs up my desktop, my wife's laptop, stores all of our photos, music, a small collection of DVD and Blu-ray rips, our important documents, and I use it as an archive for all of the videos I've ever made online going all the way back to 2009. With a total of 18 terabytes of user accessible space, I'm a little less than half full. It'll be a couple of years before I need to bump up my storage, and that's only if I keep everything I ever make, which I probably won't. If your needs aren't as high as a silly internet content creator and video producer, you'll probably be fine with a lot less overall storage. By comparison, it's pretty common to see the top cloud offering somewhere around 1 or 2 terabytes of storage. Google One is a great example. 2 terabytes of storage for $100 a year. That's not bad. But every year, you pay $100. How long will you need access to your info? Probably the rest of your life? A single bay 2 terabyte networked hard drive can often be found for around $200. You pay that once, and then you won't need to buy anything else until you run out of space or until that drive fails. Depending on your storage needs, that might be years later where you aren't having to pay a more expensive yearly subscription. The trade-off, of course, you have to manage and support that hardware. If you pay for Google or Microsoft or Apple Cloud, those companies will maintain their own servers. If you run your own NAS, you've got to make sure you clean out the fans and deal with backups and handle any issues with your home network on your own. Still, if your storage needs are growing, I wouldn't want to even try and price out Google storage for 18 terabytes of cloud per year. Which brings me to speed. Networked storage can get crazy fast depending on your home network. Stepping up to a slightly nicer NAS enclosure, you're basically buying a small computer, a small server whose main job is handling big chunks of data. But it can do a bunch of other things too. It's a computer. In addition to being a big lump of storage, the box itself can tackle media center duties. We store music and movies on ours, and those files can be streamed to any screen or speakers in our home. I really like Plex, but I think it's way handier to run Plex off of a networked drive than on a full PC. We can use this NAS as a backup for our cloud storage, you know, make sure it's redundant. My wife's phone automatically backs up to the NAS whenever she's on the home Wi-Fi and her phone is plugged in and charging. Her photo and video backups happen faster than on cloud storage, and we don't have to worry about whether they're full quality backups or compressed images. You can run developer tools. You can plug a NAS into the back end of a website. Local storage for certain kinds of security cameras. Integration with services like IFTTT to trigger specific actions at certain events. I edit all of my videos by storing my files on the NAS, and that's absolutely not something I could do if I were uploading all of my 4K video files to OneDrive. I can play Tetris on my NAS. I probably won't ever play Tetris on my NAS. But I totally can. And all of this happens at the full speed of your home network. We recently covered upgrades like Wi-Fi 6, and I've talked about using a faster router for better local file management. So think about what happens when you open a cloud storage app to look at older videos that you might have uploaded. You know, sometimes there can be a lag in opening those folders or scrolling through older files. Now, often there's a buffering or a lower quality stream that starts before the quality improves. Using my NAS on a good router, there is almost no perceptible difference in quality and speed accessing those files over my network as there might be if the hard drive were connected directly to my computer. It feels the same. Now, when I'm out and about, my connection does feel more cloud-like, and that totally depends on the upload speeds from your home network and the download speeds you have when you try to stream. But the local file transfers are crazy fast. As you might have been able to tell, I'm a really big fan of running your own network storage. I think it's a great tool in our kit to manage our data, to improve on media backups and media streaming, and to keep more control over our most important information. Literally, it's a box under your total control. You can't tell Google or Apple to just unplug your cloud if you're concerned about your data. So I see this as a wonderful complement to using a traditional cloud service, you know, that's more for the immediate convenience. But then for your home network, you can tailor fit the exact right technology for your long-term storage and streaming needs. I can ramble on about this kind of stuff all day. So if you want me to do that, drop some comments down below and we can check out more specific applications and products for your home networking. As always, thanks so much for watching, for sharing these videos and subscribing to the channel. For reviews.org, I'm Juan Carlos Bagnell, and I'll catch you all on the next video.